Buller and welcome to Canterbury Live. It is Wednesday, the 16th of July. Yes, I am back. Bit of a tan. I've got a smile because the crew apparently can't see me. Isn't that funny? No, not really. But Pure Fiji is where I was, and that who's been spoiling you over the last week. And I believe there's been lots of entries into the Pamper Packs each day. Remembering, of course, there's the big pack of $280 that'll be drawn shortly. But the winner for today is Uni O'Neill. So congratulations to you. You win a Pamper Pack. Now, the next clue, I couldn't pick between the images, and here they are. The key words for today are Pure Fiji. There I am on Monday on a lovely island with some lovely boys and the girls who are performing to us. Very, very cool. Can't believe it was only a couple of days ago. And that's all thanks to Pure Fiji. Pretty special, isn't it? And also, before we go any further, I just wanted to say a big thank you to Lisa Jordan that looked after you while I was away. Lisa is a wonderful angel that is part of our CTV family here. Well, on with the show. Now, we meet up with an old mate of mine, David Clearwater, and he's talking about his business and what's happening at the moment. And we head out to Rangiravet and we're meeting Roger Rabbit. Didn't realise he was still around. But first up, I'm with now a very talented young man. I'm joined by Kieran Sinclair Lomax. Kieran, how are you today?
Good.
Excellent. Now, what is the instrument that you play?
Piano.
And why the piano of all instruments?
I just like the sound.
And do you have a favourite pianist or?
No.
You're just drawn to it. Great. Well, should we check out how wonderful you are now? Great. Mm-hmm. Here we are. So this is a piece with Kieran. Well, Kieran, when you become a bit of a celebrity, we need to know facts about you. So how old are you?
I'm 9.
You're 9? Wow. And how long have you been playing the piano?
Since I was 5.
How clever. So 4 years, you're a bit of an old hat at it now. And what school do you go to?
Clarkville School. It's in Kaipoi.
Very cool. North Canterbury. You have to be a big shout out to the school out there. Now, tell me, you're very good at maths as well, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you think that's helped with your music?
Yeah, it helps me with piano because it's kind of all maths.
It is, isn't it? Can you explain why it is all about maths?
It's like rhythms and patterns in the music.
So you think it makes it easier once you have the grasp of maths?
Yeah.
Okay. What kind of music do you like to play?
Jazzy pieces.
Okay.
Like the one that you just heard. It's because they are a strange rhythm. They have a strange rhythm, and I like that because it's different.
Now, do you think you'd like to be a professional
player?
No. More of a hobby at this stage?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let's talk about school and maths. Mm-hmm. And you've said that it's a very important part.
Yeah.
What other things do you enjoy at school?
I enjoy spelling.
Spelling?
Yeah.
Okay. So do you like competing against other students?
No.
No?
No.
You wouldn't go on these big spelling competitions at all?
No.
Okay. Well, let's talk about your music. Now, you've just competed in the Festival of Arts competition. Can you tell us all about that?
Well, in my first class, it was 9 years and under.
Right.
And I got very highly commended ribbon. And in the second one, which was the Blue Sky Blues piece, it was a grade three. And it was a 9 years only. And I got third equal bronze medal to one other person.
That's wonderful.
And I got 90 points, and the first place person got 93 points.
Oh, so close. So what's the next competition you hope to enter? Is there one?
I'll just enter next year.
So this is a pretty old and boring question to ask, but does practice make perfect?
Yes, it actually helps quite a lot practicing.
And how long do you have to practice every day?
About between 15 minutes and 45 minutes.
Every day?
Not every day, 5 days a week.
Oh, you're wonderful. Well, it was an absolute pleasure meeting you today, Kieran. And I believe that we'll be seeing more of Kieran on the screens in the future. Very talented at 9 years of age, so well done to you. And good
luck
for school next week.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Now stay with us. Very excited, we're meeting Roger Rabbit.
The world has a great deal to tell. Journalists from across the world report on their home nations and the experiences of the people who live there. World Stories.
Come in and meet the locals at the Bush Inn Centre. Whether it's to grab a coffee on the go or to catch up with a friend over lunch or dinner, the Bush Inn Centre is the perfect place. With our unique range of shops, you'll find everything you're looking for and more. Our friendly locals are always happy to help. We have plenty of parking at the Bush Inn Centre, making your shopping experience just a little bit easier. So come in, meet the locals, and shop Bush Inn. You'll find us on the corner of Riccarton and Waimari Roads.
Action Removals, offering short or long-term storage facilities, full packing services, comprehensive rates, all fully insured and with 6 vehicle sizes to choose from. Earthquake repairs? Action Removals pack, move, store and return your valuable possessions stress-free. Action Removals, a family business that has been operating in Christchurch for over 10 years. Action Removals, your one-stop removal service, on time, every time. 0800 222 526.
Welcome to Caltex Redwood. We're a family-owned business proudly supporting our local community. We're open 24/7 for fuel and shop goods, and we have an amazing team of people ready to help you. Save at least 6 cents per litre using AA Smart Fuel Cards. We also offer great value on our LPG bottle fills. We have a full workshop and Bridgestone Tyre Centre. Our mechanics and tyre technicians will get your car sorted. Caltex Redwood. We're just down from St. Bede's on Main North Road. Caltex Redwood. What drives you?
Avoid the monkeys when it comes to relocating. Trust A1 Movers, a family business since 1993 that guarantees a professional job every time. We carefully handle and wrap your valued items, ensuring they have a safe journey. Secure storage and insurance options are also available.
A1 Movers, the careful, caring moving company. Oi!
Hi, let me introduce myself. My name is Jared Smith, the host of the Baby Boomer chat show, The Beat Goes On. It's an exciting time for us. We have never been on CTV before. We have our regulars like political reporter Tony Amos, movies and music with Barry Rushton, Song of the Week with Shane Hales, and every week a brand new special guest. Join us at 7 p.m. on Sunday night and keep the beat going on.
Now, I'm not sure if anyone framed Roger Rabbit, but he's definitely in the frame right now at Rangiora Vet.
Today at the Rangiora Vet Centre, Sophie checks up on Roger, a cute and fluffy stray rabbit.
Today we've got a rabbit. He was a stray rabbit brought into the clinic last week. We gave him a quick initial check over, but no one's really given him a thorough check over. And we want to make sure that he's nice and healthy. Potentially, we may rehome him, or his owner may come forward, which would be even better. But we have advertised out and about, and yeah, we're trying to make sure that he's nice and healthy, whatever happens. So we'll go and get our little rabbit. He's living in the cat ward at the moment because it's going to be a lot less stressful for him in here. So I'm just going to get him out of his house. He's quite frisky, so we just have to be a little bit careful how we handle him. You've got to be really careful with rabbits. They can break their backs really easily by kicking back with their back legs. So hence I've got a towel to try and help cuddle him up and hold him well. So I don't think he's been handled too much, but I've got him nice and safely in the towel here. His back's nice and supported, and I've got his back legs as well, so he's not going to hurt himself, and hopefully he's not too stressed. So let's take him through and see what we can see. Right, so here is our rabbit. He's quite a scaredy bunny, and he's going to be quite frisky, I think, and try and get away from me. So I've just got to give him as best a check as I can without stressing him out too much. So first I'm going to check his eyes. They look pretty good. Rabbits have a third eyelid like cats and dogs, and you can see that just there, that little pinky white membrane. He's got lovely loppy ears, and they seem nice and clean, which is good. Rabbits can get upper respiratory tract infections, and ear infections and eye infections. Quite often it's a Pasteurella bug, so we need to check that his nose is clean, which it is. And I'm going to try, he won't like it, but I'm going to try and have a look at his little teethies. And he's got good front teeth there, really good, so they're nice and short, and they're not causing him any problems. So rabbits' teeth grow throughout their lifetime, and they're constantly worn down by chewing grass. And we run into problems with rabbits when they don't have enough chewy stuff to chew on, and it doesn't grind the teeth down well enough, and the teeth aren't quite aligned. And what happens is that the back teeth grow quite long, and then they basically open up the front of the jaw, and because the front teeth usually rely on each other to wear themselves down, they overgrow, making it harder and harder for the poor bunny to eat. You've heard the stories about rabbits and how quickly they reproduce. They are sexually mature at around 4 to 8 months of age. So if you've got a male and a female rabbit, technically they could have babies quite quickly, and the female's only pregnant for 30 days before she has a litter. So it's important, if you've got a rabbit, to know whether it's a girl or a boy, get that checked at the vet. But if you've got rabbits at home, we should be vaccinating them against Khaleesi virus, so that's really important. So we'll keep him here in the cattery, and fingers crossed his owner will show up soon. I suspect he's an escaped pet. I really do. I mean, he's the wrong breed for being a wild one. He's nice and young. He's in beautiful condition. I think he's been really well looked after. And I think he's just, escaped somehow and ended up with us.
Be watching next week when we find out more on pain relief with vet surgeon Rebecca Waite.
Wasn't Roger beautiful? What a lovely rabbit. Well, a lucky winner we have now. Diana Burke, congratulations to you. You are the winner of the tickets for La Boheme. So we'll get those out to you, or you can pop in and see us here on Wairakei Road at CTV. Now, after the break, I catch up with David Clearwater, a fellow Southlander.
Meet the latest arrivals at Berlin's two animal parks and find out what it takes to be a zoo baby in a modern zoo. Zoo Juniors. Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. right here on CTV.
Spectacular rugby being played in the Press Cup 2014. Get your copy. DVDs available. Call right now, $29.95.
I'm Mark, and welcome to Stay Well Pharmacy. Whatever the season, Stay Well Pharmacy has you covered. As an integrated pharmacy, we stock all the well-known pharmacy medicines, as well as quality nutritional and herbal treatments. Our team of pharmacists and full-time naturopath are here to help you find the products and advice to suit the needs of you and your family. So come in and see us at Stay Well Pharmacy, 27 Shands Road in Hornby. Stay Well Pharmacy. Live well, stay well.
Let's face it, everyone has an agenda. And guess what? So do I. Every week, I'll pick three stories that grab my attention. Agenda with me, Brent Goff.
Now, I was just chatting with David before. It's actually 15 years you've been coming onto CTV.
No, 13 years. Yeah, 13. We were 2 years before we come in here.
Oh,
yeah.
Right.
So it's been a while. It's just time, I don't know, time goes so fast, eh? It's incredible.
But don't you look back now and think, you know, starting in a modest way, and look now how the business has just thrived. I mean...
Well, that's it, yeah. Yeah, it's been a huge transformation from a little town of Winton of 2,000 people where you're a one-man band and perhaps had an apprentice, which I did, always had one person working for me. And then you come up here to the big city and obviously one's not enough. You've got to get up to 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then before the recession, we got down to about 5 or 6 of us. We're starting to panic. You know, every day we're looking for where's the next job coming from. And then, of course, the earthquakes hit the city. And all of a sudden, we're up over 20. I think we hit 23, one part of it. Yeah. We're down to about 20 now.
Well, let's educate those viewers that haven't met you before,
Dave.
What's the background of your business? What's the essence?
Basically, we're painting, decorating, and renovating. So we can do all your painting requirements, all your wallpaper requirements, basically anything to do with decorating. We've got our own builder in-house. We've got electricians on tap. We can do tiling as well. So we've got a tiler that'll come and do our work straight away. We've got a plasterer who'll work for us straight away. So for anybody who does want to do an alteration job inside a house, and that's where we've always focused, even before the earthquake, we were doing a lot of this. It's a one-stop shop. So basically they give us a call. I go out and talk to people. They then go to town, pick what wallpaper they want, pick what paints they want, fixtures and fittings, and then we just come and put it all together for them.
So Dave, in essence, you're probably project managing it really for us, aren't you?
Yeah, we project manage it, and that's where the earthquakes hit. We start off obviously with Fletcher's, and they like the companies that could do all that in-house. Mm. And of course, we did a lot for work for Fletcher's, and then the opt-out, we heard about the opt-out. So of course, with being on CTV, I come on here and I says, hey, we can do your repairs. And the phone went nuts. So we've never been back to Fletcher's.
Funny that,
since.
Dave.
The phone, yeah, it did. It kept ringing and ringing and ringing. And we basically increased our staff by about a third overnight.
Right.
And we've never gone back to Fletcher's, which is all opt-out work and working direct for the homeowner. And in the first 6 months, I would say half the people that we worked for in that particular part of it were existing customers. Because I always wondered, how can I do existing customers' work? Because work was being given to us from another party.
Yeah.
And the opt-out worked perfect for us. And we're still doing it. That's what we do now. And just keep going to work every day. Phone keeps ringing and keep doing the work.
No job's too big or small though, is it, Dave?
Well, we like to stick under 100,000. You know, there's big jobs out there, but we stick in that range under 100,000, and it's easier managed for us. And that's the area we like to work in. So we've got a couple on the go at the moment, around the 70,000 to 80,000. So yeah, that's good.
There's a reason why though you've stuck around for this long, isn't it? Because, I mean, can we be quite frank, there's a lot of cowboys out there, isn't there?
Yeah, a lot of cowboys have come in and a lot of cowboys are going too. If you read the paper lately, the bankruptcies and receiverships in the paper is unbelievable at the moment. And the painters and builders, and anyone has to wonder why. Mm. But we're established company, good name, and basically our company's cash rich, so we don't have overdrafts, we don't use them, and we got a good company and good people that work for us, and that's been a big help for us in the last couple of years. We started employing females. And we've got up to seven female staff now, qualified painters and wallpapers, and it's really changed the way our company's gone. You know, I got Erin in the office, and she's telling me what to do now. It's really good. Sometimes.
Trust is a big thing, though, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely, yes. We've got to trust the people that work around me, and we have got good people that you can rely on, and they're very good with the homeowners. That's the key to our success as well. They treat everybody's house as if it's their own.
What do people say when they, because it's a big thing letting someone into your home that you don't know, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. First presentation is like, we've got all good gear, and I'm a real stickler, you know, got to have good tidy vans, you know, clean vans, tidily dressed. And the first 10 minutes, of walking into a person's house is the probably the most key part of it, because human nature is you sum a person up instantly.
Yeah.
And our guys are good at doing that, and they get in there, and then people can relax, and then they realise at the end of the day they're going to get a good job, and they do. That's where you have pride in doing a good job, and do it once, do it properly.
Dave, do you get what you pay for?
Oh, absolutely. If people, you know, we always talk about people screwing you down and screw you down for price, but at the end of the day, you can only do a good job at a fair price. And if people, you know, you want a cheap job, don't come to us, because you can't do a good, cheap job. So you do get what you pay for. It pays to spend a little bit more, and then you get quality, because the tradesman can actually spend a little bit more time on site and get the finer details. And the finishing is in the finer detail, especially with wallpaper. Like, anybody can throw up wallpaper and get it up on the wall, but I'll teach you later.
Okay.
To cut it off nice and square and get the lines nice and straight, it takes time. Get your joints so you can't see your lines, and it costs to do it, you know. So the guys are good and girls are good at doing it.
So apart from, obviously, I mean, a great business, you've got people that you trust in that.
Yeah.
A little bit about Dave behind the scenes.
Oh, me?
Yeah. You actually do give back, though, don't you, with Lions?
Oh, yeah, yes, we are. My wife's been Lions, she's probably been 25 years now in Lions. She's been right at the top of the South Island as Lions. And I'm tied up in Lions. I probably do, I don't know, 20 hours a month voluntary work myself for Lions. I squeeze it in my work.
Great.
Yeah, so do a bit.
Yeah, so let's look at some images that you have for us, Dave, and let's talk about some, wow.
Okay, this is the thing, everybody knows that we do roofs, so we're not too scared of getting up nice and high. That's an older roof out at Dunsandel. We'll water blast it down, tighten down all the loose nails, do any repairs that are required, and then painted it.
Very nice.
Yeah, no, it came out good. We don't do a lot of commercial work, so it does come along every now and again, and we're happy to do that. So we do the bigger jobs. This is Autotech in Rangiora. We painted the whole building, and then the signwriter obviously put the signs on. Yeah. Another commercial building on Carmen Road there, it's bright yellow. Hamish and Cobber of Ayres, it used to be the old Goodyear Tyre Centre, so I'll give a plug for Hamish. Mm. They turned themselves into a AA service centre.
Pretty spiffy car up front there, Dave.
Pretty cool, isn't it?
Who's that?
Oh, I think it could belong to Hamish. No, I think it belongs to me, actually. Hamish would like to think he owns it. That was a toy to myself.
Because that's rallying that you do, isn't it? So.
Yes, we've done that for 25 years, yeah.
Yeah.
Our tiling, this is just a picture. We come in, lift up all your tiles. It's not a very good photo, but it just shows we do cover up people's furniture and kitchen joineries and stuff like that, because the last thing we want to do is chip up a floor and put a dent in something.
Yeah, it's important.
Yeah. That's our builder and our labour, old Ed. Ed's been with me 10 years this year. He's due to retire. But these guys took an old chimney out. This house here, we took that whole wall out and opened it right up, made the two rooms into one big room. So those type of jobs are really good for us. We like doing that type of thing, and it's good. This is an earthquake repair house. It was done up the top of the hill, up the Yolverton, up in that area. And there was a lot of rejibbing in that house. So we did a lot of rejibbing. We plastered it all, painted it all. All the tiles downstairs were all redone. And we were there for probably about 6 weeks on that particular dwelling. And then we did the neighbours as well.
Well, surely that must come back to word of mouth then.
Well, those customers ended up with three jobs from that one job. So it worked out really, really good, yeah.
Great. So the first thing we need to do is, if we are contemplating anything, is really just give you a call and have a chat, Dave.
Yeah, the first thing is to give us a call and I'll come and have a look at the job. And if we can do it, we will. If we can't do it, I can just point you in the direction of people that can. Because some things we can't do. But, it's really simple.
Good seeing you, mate.
Yeah, good.
Take care. So all we need to do is call 0800 766 378 for Dave and the team. Thank you so much for joining me today. It's wonderful to be back here in Canterbury, especially here on Canterbury Live. Just a reminder that we do have some double passes for the Tommy Dorsey concert on Saturday. Call 03 377 033 and we'll see you tomorrow.